Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings. Good evening. Good morning. Good whatever the balls it is for you. Yes. I'll pretend to care. What is this? What is this, you might ask? Well, I did say that I would see about streaming some of my research. Now, everyone, I think most people know that I play the game for a little while before I do my WTFs, and depending on what game it is, depends on how long I do that for. So I thought, well, why not stream a bit of that? Because I'm going to play it anyway, so why not let people see the kind of process, I suppose, that goes into that? So in this case, this is Stick It to the Man, which is a platformer. Yeah, I know. You'll understand why I'm playing it in a minute. It's a platformer by a company called Zoink. Came out mid last month, and it's something that slipped through the net. It's something I wanted to look at, but I didn't have the time to do it. Now I do, so I'm going to have a look at this. Let me know, by the way, if the background sound is too loud, because I'm going to have to mess around with it on a game-by-game basis. So if you have a problem with the level of the sound, then please let me know. And once I know that it's right, we will begin. And interestingly enough, they have this particular song, which is a licensed track in the background. I'm probably going to have to mute that pretty hard for YouTube, otherwise I might get claimed on that. Which is goddamn infuriating, by the way. It's like, yeah, you're going to review or critique or first impressions of the game. Oh, it's got licensed music in it? Then we own the video. Fuck off! Absolute bollocks. Alright. Yeah, cool. Well, there's nothing out of ordinary in the options menu that I'm probably going to highlight. Although it is kind of weird that on the main screen, the cursor actually works now. When I first loaded it up on the main screen, it didn't actually have a cursor, but this was still mouse-driven, and then the options had it, so... Oh, well, never mind. But yeah, I'm not recording the WTFs now, it's just my research for it. So I'm going to play it for a bit and try and figure out what's going on with it, so that when I actually come to do my video, I actually know what's happening.
Where am I?
Alright, I'll run the...
What's this spaghetti arm doing sticking out of my head?
Okay, this is a tad unusual. Well, I'll run the subtitles underneath, so if I end up talking over cutscenes, you'll at least know what's been going on.
Jumping a lot. And then... getting it on the head. Of course! The hand growing out of my head, and this whole crazy world is all a dream.
Yeah, someone made the... What the hell? What, you can actually move the hand around individually? Alright, interesting. That's... I wonder what that's gonna do with the mechanics. So, like, the first thing that people look at when they look at this game is like, oh, look at the aesthetic. It's like, yeah, you're right, the aesthetic is amazing. Like, you haven't seen the half of it. Some of the aesthetic of this game is absolutely fantastic. But this hand, I can actually... It turns out I can control that with the cursor keys. So I have a feeling there was some dual stick stuff going on there. So, alright, we'll see how this works out.
Hey, a bottle. Nice work, me. Oh.
Psychic
arm. My subconscious.
Bloody hell.
Inside it to help me get off.
Well, I hate it when they do that. It's like, yeah, use this. Like, do I even... I don't have my pad plugged in. So, yeah, that's a sign of a bad port right there. All right, let's find out what the buttons are. I can't find out what the buttons are because it doesn't have access to the controls. All right, let's randomly bash buttons until we figure out which one is the right one. Oh, fucking hell. The mouse, I assume. There we go. Pull right! You can control the arm with the mouse as well. Okay, right. Let's do that then.
High five me, Ray.
High five me, Ray.
I give the best high fives, Ray.
High five me instead.
Ray, you may think you know high fives, but you haven't experienced a high five until you've high fived me.
Please, please, crazy pin creatures. One at a time.
Hang on.
High five Ollie, I promise.
Sounded really suspiciously like the...
Crazy hand for something.
What's the... Yeah, the Charlie the Unicorn videos? I wonder if they had anything to do with that. I'm going to have to look at that later, because that might be an interesting trivia point for the video. Grab red pins and swing at them. Alright, so... Huh, so I actually can't control this with the mouse.
A cork is
a bit weird. That's a bit strange. Okay, so... This is pretty badly put together, in the sense that the port requires you to control your arm with the cursor keys here, but then click in order to actually use it. So you're using the mouse and that, and you can't move at the same time because you don't have three fucking arms! Jeez.
High five me, Ray.
This has got to be the guy from Charlie the Unicorn. Oh, hang on.
What? This arm is awesome.
Oh, okay. I think the moving of the arm actually doesn't matter. Like, I think it's just an aesthetic thing. So when you click...
Yeah!
when you click on it with the mouse, that's what happens. Okay, so I'm all right with that. It's just, it was a little confusing from the start, and the fact that it showed gamepad controls when I'm clearly not using a gamepad was pretty dumb. All right. I don't know if you can rebind the keys. If you can, you can't do it from here. So I'd have to, like, exit the game to check that. Again, that's something that I'll be looking into for the video itself. But yeah, you don't have to use the 360 pad, but it seems a bit damn awkward if you don't. This works fine with the keyboard and mouse, but they don't bother to tell you what the controls are, so you have to pretty much guess. Like, even at the start of the game, it didn't tell me what the movement controls are or what the jump key was. I just made an assumption that it would be WASD in space, and it turns out that it was. I mean, aesthetically, the game's gorgeous. I think, actually, this area is not as good-looking as the other one. There's film grain on it as well, isn't there? Yeah. I was looking at this like, hang on a second, that looks a bit grainy. Yeah, there's actual film grain on it. And you obviously see the shadows around the side there.
Hey, cool! Interesting aesthetic decision. Wait, these colossal fingers look familiar.
Right. I mean, so far, for the most part, it's just a bunch of platforming. I do have this cork, but I don't know if that actually does anything.
Oh, wow, no way! A giant me robot!
Okay. Grab the fold and rip it off. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, okay. So again, that worked fine with the mouse. All I did was I clicked on it and then dragged down, so that actually worked
fine. Inside are a bunch of gears that aren't moving, which probably means I'm knocked out, and I need to drain the water from my brain. Got it.
Help! Help! I can't hold my breath forever!
Oh, and there's a creature swimming around in my head. Not sure what to make of that one, honestly. Can you hear me, little guy?
Help! Help! I can't hold my breath forever!
Huh. Apparently not.
Well, I think it's pretty clear the fucking voice acting and characterization as well as the aesthetic of this game is the obvious strength of it.
Hey, a sticker of a tap. I wonder if it's scratch and sniff.
Right.
It is.
Okay, so you can move
it
items around.
Like a sticker. Neat.
So I assume that's going to stop him drowning, one would think. Let's touch him.
Pink
there.
Pink elephant
there
pouring water through a hole in my head.
Then cork it up. Okay.
All
right, so that's how the item system works. That makes sense.
Finally dry at last.
Vignette. That's it, yeah.
I
couldn't quite remember exactly what it was.
If only there was a way to get that heart working again.
All right, so what's broken? So we've got to fix the heart, which, as you might imagine, would be further down. There we go. Okay, so there's more paper there.
Yoo-hoo, heart! Come here, heart! Heart! Come here, girl! I miss you!
Leanne, my girlfriend lives in Robot Me's heart, and she's calling for a dog named Heart. Dreams are crazy. Oh well, at least I'm not back in high school and also naked in this one. Again.
I think I would call the voice acting a strength, because I think that it suits what the game is all about. You don't have to have Shakespearean voice acting or anything along those lines. You just have to have the voice acting suit exactly what's happening within the game. I wonder what happens if you jump in here. Okay, so oh, that's cool. Look at that. There's a lot of interesting little details in this game. So you respawn at any of those checkpoints. It makes sense. So we're looking for a dog of some sort. Let's see if there's any other stickers that we can grab up here. Can we go that high? Yeah, of course we can. Don't think we can go any higher than that, though. Alright. So, the arms platform. Interesting. Okay. Didn't notice that. Graphically, it actually reminds me a little bit of The Puppeteer and also a little bit of Tearaway, but obviously this game's been in development for quite some time.
Oh, hey there, little guy. You're Heart, Arlene's dream dog, aren't you? How's it going, Heart? Oh, there's a good girl.
Okay, can we actually pull him? No, we can't grab him, so I guess we'll have to just... Huh. The shadow's quite nice, look at that. I wonder if that... I mean, that's got to be the light source, surely. No, that can't be the light source, that's behind him. So the light source is actually coming from me, technically. Alright. Well, that's completely and totally useless. There we go. It is a bit Rayman-esque. It's not as quick as Rayman, though. Less about collecting.
Ahoy, matey! Greetings! I be Redbeard the Scary. I'll have you know that back in my day, I was the most feared pirate on all the seven seas.
Bad news, buddy. You're just a figment of my imagination. And this... It's all a dream.
You? Aye. It occurs to me that in real life, skeletons don't talk. Will you do an old sea dog a favor and dream me back to life again?
Well, I kind of need to lead this dog back to my girlfriend. You've got an arm made of bone, so...
I hear you, landlubber. Well, I'd be happy to lend a hand.
Well, Doc, 2 points for the puns.
Oh, I just realized how well lend a hand worked back there. That wasn't even on purpose.
Heart, come.
Lies. How can he jump higher than me? BS. Absolute nonsense. Badumtish indeed. Suits me. All the puns. There you go. Where'd he go? Oh, he's coming that way. Okay. That's... So he can jump higher than me, yet he won't do that pathing. Interesting. All right. There you go.
Heart, you came back. What a good girl. Who's a good girl? It's you, Heart. You're the best girl. Yes, you are. I'm so happy. I love you, Heart.
I always knew Eileen was the woman of my dreams. But it's nice to have it confirmed.
All the pieces are in place. I was just about to leave, but now I think I'll stay after all. Yes, I'll be able to stay here indefinitely. As long as the host survives.
Wait, what?
Oh. Never mind then.
Sir, there's been an... incident.
An incident?
A crash, sir. And the subject is... missing.
Why are you coming to me for instructions? Obviously, I'm going to tell you to find it. It's the most powerful weapon in the universe.
Spaghetti! Spaghetti in my hand! You think? Wow! What a crazy dream! Oh, good thing dreams are stupid and don't mean anything!
You're awake! Perfect. That'll be a lot easier than carrying you out.
Huh? What will be easier than carrying me out?
This. Get out!
What?
Your insurance doesn't cover head injuries, mister. Get out!
Head injury? What? What happened to my head? Hey, quit shoving! Will you just tell me what happened to my head? Hey, easy on the buns!
Well, there you go then. Yeah. As I was saying earlier that the level 2, you thought, you know, the aesthetic might be good, but I actually prefer the aesthetic in the main world here. It's very nicely done with colored pencil. There's a lot of cutouts in the foreground and the background there, which look very, very nice. And overall, it's a little bit weird that they'd actually obstruct your view like that, but I guess it doesn't really matter when there's nothing on the screen that can kill you.
It's just all kinds of itchy.
I should just tell it to him straight.
Oh,
This can't be happening!
Ouch! Careful!
I will bite you! I will do it right
so
under
you! Shiny.
Become a
so
ship,
say
Sid. Your patrons
I can't do it without it! Holy crap! What the hell? Okay. I'm hallucinating. Arms don't grow out of heads. I just gotta get home and sleep this off. It's all a hallucination, that's all. It's just a hallucination that lets me read minds accurately.
So, you know when I said that I like to get pretty far into a game before I actually do the video? This is why, like, especially with modern games, because they're very, very cutscene intensive, and this game has no ability to skip cutscenes at all. So if I had done a video from chapter 2, half it would have been bloody cutscenes. So yeah, there is a reason behind everything we do on the channel, and that is one of them. But you do get to see some funny cutscenes and listen to some pretty good music, which is actually very LucasArts-esque, but someone pointed out Grim Fandango, you're absolutely right, it does sound an awful lot like that. And it also has some Psychonauts looks to it. I mean, it is very Double Fine.
Listen, do me a favor, I kinda didn't think this through.
Obviously.
And I left the handbrake on in the car. Could you disengage it for me?
Actually, maybe you can do me a favor instead. I'm looking for a cab ride home, and...
I got my own problems here. Problems I do not want to talk about. Listen, thanks for nothing. I'm just gonna wait here till somebody else comes and disengages my car. Peace!
Maybe I can use my hallucination brain arm to read his mind and find out what his problem is. I don't know.
Press the button that doesn't exist to enter mind reading mode. You know what's ridiculous about this is I believe this game first came out on the PlayStation, not on the sodding 360, and yet it's giving me 360 controls anyway. Okay, I'm gonna guess. Let's see how good my prediction are. That this is right mouse button. Hey! There you go. Grab people's brains to hear their thoughts. That's the left mouse button.
If only you hadn't left me for that mafia don with the mad nutty smile. If only my own smile had that sparkle that drives you wild. If only I could take back years of poor dental hygiene. If only I could have you back.
Okay, so the puzzle is let's fix his teeth.
This dude get his lady friend back.
And there is also disco.
Keep it up, Barbara. We'll win this competition for sure. Especially since my biggest challenger had an unfortunate accident.
What? Huh? What was that? Sorry, I was kind of lost in your teeth there. I just love your smile, Don.
Don's my position, not my you know what? Don's fine.
Honey, I don't care what you're called, as long as you keep showing me those sparkly teeth.
For those asking whether or not I have a pad plugged in, I actually don't know. My pad is not plugged in, so it's not auto-detecting that. Even if it was, it shouldn't be. You know, a good port will usually alternate between pad control tooltips and keyboard and mouse control tooltips when it detects which one you're using. So I don't really know what's going on with that. Okay, so I need to somehow help this person with their teeth.
Ed, where are you? We've been practicing for weeks, and the parents won't stand me up.
Oh,
don't do this to me, Eddie.
You can actually fast forward and rewind it using A and D.
I am an adult human, and my major criteria in selecting a mate is how shiny their teeth are. I may have made some bad decisions somewhere. However, on the other hand,
shiny teeth.
Yeah, I'm starting to like the dialogue in this game, I gotta say. I was just messing around with the rewind. What's going on with this?
Some might say that murdering a man to win a dance competition is sociopathic. But is it really sociopathic to only see people as obstacles to be overcome by any means possible? Wait, maybe it is. Maybe. That's actually the textbook symptom of sociopathy. Oh well, too late now.
I wonder if it's actually possible to accelerate the cutscenes in the same way. Huh. I want to know what's inside this guy's head, because good lord.
This can't stop this dance train.
Apparently we can't stop the dance train, which is reasonable. Alright. This is... I gotta say, like, the dialogue to this game is definitely the high point. Like, I'm not convinced by the gameplay yet, but... dialogue and presentation is spot on. Okay. Press yet another button you don't fucking have access to in order to bring the map to the level. Let's try backspace. No. Delete. End. No. Page down. No. Press all the... Okay, so apparently E also doubles for right mouse button for no apparent reason. Da-da-da-da-da. Let's try M. Okay. Yeah, common sense. There we go. Bloody
useless.
Unless
my good friend Bitey comes and eats it first.
Most ethical idea. Bitey.
There appears to be a dragon in here.
Chicken. I'm nature's greatest predator, buddy. And I'm tired of chicken. I got a taste for special treats, and I ain't coming out for anything except human limbs, baby. Delicious human limbs. So long and crunchy. So full of valuable vitamins and minerals.
Chicken myself.
To be fair, this game has a hell of a lot of dialogue in it to the point where it might really get annoying, because you've got to really listen to everybody. So... it's weird that this is a puzzle platform. It'd actually make more sense if this was a point and click.
Poor Bitey. All alone and lost in the sewer. Nobody to tuck him in at night. Nobody to give him his belly rubs and his teeth scratches. Bitey's such a gentle soul.
He needs me to take care of him.
Can I steal the chicken? Negative. It will not let me do that.
I can't wait to eat all
this. So I need human flesh to solve that. So it seems like this game kind of has opened up at this point, and you've got to solve all these various different problems at the same time. So that's kind of neat. I like that. It's, you know, a little bit less irritating than the standard linear fix this to go on kind of thing. Alright. Come on, I should be able to jump up there. Stop it. Jump controls are a little awkward. I mean, I don't really get the impression the game would ever really go... full on towards needing precision jumping or anything, especially considering you can use this hand coming out of your head to attach to things, but even then, every now and again, the controls do some weird things.
Is that you? And you brought you?
This appears to be a cat.
I never forget a smell. Those are the jerks that tortured me every day when I was a puppy. They tied firecrackers to my tail. Gosh darn it, I'd eat them alive if only I had my teeth. I need teeth, darn it!
Everyone seems to be obsessed with teeth right now.
What's the big idea? Get any closer and I'll get my brother to beat you up. Understand? Faith. It's good to be the big brother. Boys, later.
Oh gosh, Rachel's gonna kill me if I don't make it to the disco competition on time. Only she won't, because I'll already be dead. Because these guys are gonna kill me real soon. This is it, Ed. You're going to be dead soon, and you never went skydiving. You never ate caviar, and you never beat the Silver Surfer game for the NES. You're gonna die with regrets, Edo. Oh, if only I'd spent more time learning how to escape from Trunks instead of learning the enemy attack patterns in the Silver Surfer for the NES. Although, honestly, I'm glad I spent so much time playing Silver Surfer for the NES. That game was tight.
No, it wasn't. It was terrible. Don't... you sit upon a throne of lies. Okay, so... we have determined thus far that that's the dance partner that's missing. We've got to get some teeth, we've got to get a human arm somehow. I have a feeling that getting the teeth might be connected to the human arm thing. Let's see what we can find. Hello. What is this? It's a... can? Does... and that might replace the teeth? I don't know. Let's... we'll see what the dog has to say about that.
Wrong sticker.
Okay, so that's clearly not it. It really is a point-and-click platformer, isn't it? Because, like, apply something to something else and just keep trying until things actually work out. So, who exactly do I give this to?
Wrong sticker.
You can just try everything and hope it works. Seems like the way to do it. Thank you. I don't think you can actually put anything in the inventory. I think you can only carry one thing at a time from what I can see. Alright, what's going on with these guys?
What a kind and noble heart here breaks.
Alright, so the fish has something to say.
This can't be real, can it? I thought we'd be together forever. Forever! Oh, I can't believe our relationship is over.
Alright.
I hate to see him hurt, but it had to be done, right? It had to be done. Breakups suck, but I still care for him. I just wish everything didn't have to be so sucky.
What is that? I'm rubbing my hands all over it, but I don't know what it's for. What the hell? So, I somehow stole his tears, but I think I lost my other item. Oh no, no! Aha! Aha ha ha!
I'm not sure this.
You can actually switch items using the mouse button. Again, something that the game didn't bother to fucking tell you.
I'm not sure this fits.
Okay. Let's see if there's any more building stuff that we can. Oh, hello, that's loose. What is that? Here, have some tears!
L'ingredient parfait! This meal, it is. Perfection. Perfection! You can really taste the sorrow.
Aha, okay. Now we steal that. Which he somehow doesn't seem to care about in any way.
It's a new piece de resistance! Though I am lying in the gutter of this restaurant and its swine patrons, I can nevertheless show them the stars!
Alright then. Okay, so that's the arm for Mr. Bitey down here.
I can't wait to eat all this chip.
Bitey! You came back! Come on, let me hug you for a bit. Laura and the kids will be ecstatic to see you again. They may show it by screaming at us and running away, but that's just their way.
All right, now we steal his teeth. He's... Aww. I fixed somebody's relationship with a giant man-eating alligator. That was wonderful.
I feel empty inside. Inside my mouth, anyway.
Oh, there you go. Alright, so now we take the teeth. So, yeah, I see how this goes. You solve one puzzle, which gives a nightmare to solve the next puzzle, which... So, I have a feeling that most of these levels are gonna go along the lines of explore everything, find out everybody's problems, then find the logical place to start and keep on going. And if you can't find that, then rip off all the paper from the back until you do.
Remember that?
Oh, alright, have some teeth!
Beatrice? Is that Beatrice? Where did you get those teeth? Good doggy. Good doggy.
Carry me, Luigi. Carry me and then run faster, Luigi.
Okay,
come
can I use.
Any time, boys.
Lovely. Can I use the hole, I wonder, to actually let him out of there? Yes, you can. Instead of, you know, just opening the trunk, which would have made more sense.
How can I ever say thanks?
Well, I could use a drive.
I've got it. I'll dance for you, and then we can talk about Silver Surfer.
Oh, fuck.
For the NES?
Aw, man, I really want to talk about this, but I'm late.
Ed! You made it! Where were you?
Locked in a trunk, but this stranger wandered in and helped me out.
It's been a good day for that, I think. Let's dance.
An amazing set! First place goes to... Rachel and Ed! For their routine, Rachel's Education in Dance!
This is an outrage! I paid good money to ensure my victory! I'm so angry, I could swallow my teeth! I could literally swallow my...
I'll save you, Don.
I'll save you, Don's teeth!
The disco train does not stop, as you can see.
Can't stop this dance train.
It is literally unstoppable. Get Chris Pine in here immediately. Let's steal his teeth, take them back, and give them a happy reunion.
These teeth are so sparkly. They feel good. They feel right. What am I doing here? I need to go show Barbara. Barbara, I'm back, and I got a mouthful to say to you.
Bernie, is that you? You're so sparkly. Oh, Bernie, where did we go wrong?
We didn't, Barbara. Just forget it. Everything up to now is non-canon.
Lol.
Canonicity starts right now.
Hey, thanks for the ride home, Bernie.
Thanks for reminding me what's really important. Love.
Sparkly teeth.
Well, I can see people that are very mechanically orientated like myself fucking hating this. because frankly, like, it's almost all story. There's very little puzzling to go into this, and obviously the platforming is extremely basic. But I mean, it's aesthetically beautiful. But it really is a point-and-click game, basically. They just, for some reason, made it a platformer, and I don't really know why. But hey.
Aline, I'm home. I've had the craziest day, honey. Check it out. Think of a number between negative gazillion and infinity plus three. Bet you $50 I can read your mind.
Alright.
Aline, I know that the arm sticking out of my head looks weird.
The what?
The arm sticking out of my head. I know it looks weird, but...
There's no arm sticking out of your head. Ray, are you going nuts on me? Are you dropping insanity balls on the floor?
No, I don't think so. You really can't see it?
Sweetie, why don't you go see my shrink? Dr. Egglesworth helped me a lot. I'm not afraid of grapes anymore, see?
Ah, jeez. Maybe I am crazy. I guess it wouldn't hurt to see Dr. Egglesworth. I believe his office is over here, to the right.
What I wonder is if they do anything with the mechanics outside of that, because if it keeps being this for a good number of hours, I could see myself sticking with it because the dialogue is pretty good, but like I wouldn't find it a fulfilling game. It's like, so far, a lot of this, you could really just watch somebody play it and get the same experience. And I've said it before many times, this whole Let's Play problem is only a problem if you make your games like that. It's fun to watch, and it's fun to listen to, but I want games to be fun to play.
That's him! He's the one who took your sacred thingamabob! I know because he has a stupid haircut. I don't forget a haircut that dumb.
Agent 23, reporting in. We may have a positive on our target. Instructions.
Get him.
Alright, can you actually die? Okay, turns out you can actually die. That's kind of neat. Good. So, I suppose there is, that's a little bit more emphasis on the actual gameplay.
Is this real? Am I being chased by these jerks, or am I really just going totally nuts right now?
Oh, Dr. Egglesworth, if only you hadn't taken the death of your father so hard and fallen into deep depression. I'm glad you're seeing Dr. Brom. I'm also glad I'm paid by the hour. Take as long as you need, Dr. Egglesworth.
Okay, so he's seeing Dr. Brom, so let's go find Dr. Brom, of course. Avoid getting horribly murdered by goons with lasers. Nope. Well, this is not going to go too well. Oh. It's okay, they are easily outmaneuvered, but I think that's actually slightly faster than me, so I do want to watch out
later,
for that.
Possibly imaginary suckers.
This bit is very Death Spank-esque in terms of how it looks. Which is also cool, you know, I mean, those are cool places to find inspiration.
Dagnabbit, I'm dead now. Well, that's an inconvenience for me, but it's not going to shut down my practice. There's still tons of people out there who need lobotomies.
Stay away from me with your lobotomies, man. So you're not as scary as I was expecting.
I'm not scary. I'm a lobotomist. And it's the only way to cure what ails you, Sonny. A few cuts, a few slips, and you won't have a care in the world.
Right, I'm going to take a quick break if you don't mind. When I come back, we will continue Stick It to the Man research. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get back to it, shall we? Seems like a good idea. Okay, so for some reason the Doctor is dead. There's a rather annoyed Scotsman involved in it for some reason as well. We knew the Doctor was depressed, went to see Dr. Brom, who I assume we should probably try and find at some point.
There's a gentleman who loves digging 6 foot deep holes. This is basically the perfect job for me. Except for the constant and omnipresent threat of a spooky hunting.
Through my vivid.
I don't know if that's actually a Scottish accent. There's a lot of variety in accents in this game, and not all of them are legit.
When has talking about your issues ever solved anything? Action speaks louder than words, and that action is cutting out brain parts!
So, lobotomies, alright, okay. Well, let's keep going, so we don't have a solution to this yet. So we're also avoiding the agents. Okay, so it actually indicates a line of sight, but it doesn't really give you a huge amount of warning, so there seems to be some kind of minor stealth elements going on. Oh, they actually path pretty smart, too. Alright, that was unexpected. But there isn't really a penalty for death, it's just more of these bloody things being an... Well, that was a terrible idea. These bloody things just being a little bit of an obstacle. Which is fine. So they actually see you from there. I thought because he was turned the other way that wouldn't be the case, but evidently not.
Hey, those guys are snappily dressed. They're probably pretty smart.
Huh, okay.
Maybe I should mind
Well, I should have not stayed up all night last night eating burritos. And yet I have no regrets about staying up all night eating burritos.
I don't know.
Okay. So I wonder if I can send him to sleep with that. Let's see.
Oh, man. What happens if I put this sticker on an agent? Sweet!
This is starting to get a lot more interesting all of a sudden.
Oh, I probably don't have too long until they wake up.
Alright, that's a cool mechanic.
This is heavy.
So you can pull actions from the minds of people and then apply it to them or others. That's pretty neat. So you don't have any, like, direct way of doing... sort of any combat, but you have ways of bypassing people. Okay, so Dr. Brom was mentioned earlier, so he's probably the person we should be looking for. There's also an amazing traveling carnival, which is very psychonautesque. As long as there's no meat in that circus, then I don't mind. What's in here?
Excuse me, doctor? Doctors?
Dr. Brom, I can't go back to work. I just can't. Dad hated how I practiced my profession, and now that he's gone, we'll never reconcile. There's no closure left for me. I'll never be able to talk to him again.
Mm-hmm. And how does that make you feel?
Sad, I guess.
Mm-hmm. And how does that make you feel?
The sadness? Not happy, like I have emotions that are making me depressed.
Mm-hmm. And how does that make you feel?
Wait, how does that make you feel?
Fine, thank you, but we're here to discuss you.
Hey,
okay.
I gotta help Dr. Egglesworth so that he can help me. I gotta
okay, so the lobotomist is actually not the guy we're looking for, I see.
Wow, did work get a lot easier when I realized I could ask, and how does that make you feel, to every question?
If only I could talk to my dad one more time.
Get him to understand why I do what I do. I just need one last chat with him. Man, I don't need a psychiatrist. I need a medium. Or at least a necromancer. Wait,
necromancers don't really exist, do they? No, I think they're all frauds. Okay, medium it is.
Find a psychic medium somewhere. Alright. Fair enough. Well, there is an amazing traveling carnival right here. That might be the convenient place to find it. Madam Morgue. Yeah, that sounds like it might work.
Yes. I have made contact with the spirit of your dear departed wife.
I haven't departed anywhere. I can't move in the afterlife because my husband cut off my legs.
Ta-da! Is she here? Can you ask her if she's mad that I cut off her legs?
She's saying that she is, slightly frustrated by the circumstances.
If I could touch him, I'd tear his legs off too!
Yeah, definitely sensing some frustration.
What? It's almost like barely a game. It's just a click on people and hear funny dialogue simulator.
I can't walk into the light or anywhere else for that matter. Either someone needs to find me some legs, or someone needs to kill a wheelchair and send its ghost over my way.
Okay.
After I apologize for cutting off her legs, I should ask her if she knows where I put my rabbit. I haven't seen him for weeks, and rabbits don't just disappear. Oh, wait, no. I made him disappear and then couldn't get him back. Okay, yeah, note to self. Stop by pet store on the way home.
Hang on a minute. There's rabbit ears coming out of your hat, you silly bin.
How amazing it is that ghosts really do exist. And how incredible that they all want to talk with my paying customers. At least this ghost knows a language. I'm so tired of being bothered by caveman ghosts from thousands of years ago.
Okay. Find legs. It's not in his hat. It looks like it's in his hat, but it actually isn't. You can't interact with that. There may be something that you can then use to interact with the hat, but...
Balloons for sale! Balloons for sale! I've taken some of our planet's finite helium supply and put it inside a leaky, disposable balloon. You should buy it!
Okay. Let's steal the helium. Okay, what can we do with helium?
I like shapes and colors, especially when those shapes are inflated. Sometimes I wonder if this is really what I was put on this earth to do. Sometimes I get sad. A balloon. You should buy it!
Okay, let's see what else is in here. So, I mean, regardless of the addition of the action mechanics, the whole thing seems to boil down to the same. Find everybody, talk to everybody, find out what's going on, and then find the first... It's almost like finding the first domino to knock down the rest. Let's see what's
All
going
right.
on here.
Round 37. Whoever has the shortest legs gets punched. Again. Ready, Gigator? Ready, Colossus? Ready, little chump?
What? No! No!
1, 2, 3, go!
Wait, no, wait! Ow! Oh! Oh my gosh, are they? Hey, Jace! They're about to pull off the rally scene trampoline trivets maneuver! Ladies and gentlemen, this trick is very difficult to pull off. Let's watch. A complete success and a very painful landing for little chump. Ha! Poetry in motion.
So there was conveniently a set of legs there. How on earth we're gonna get access to that? That's a different matter entirely.
If my legs were longer, I wouldn't get punched. I could run away to freedom. I could follow my dreams of being in library school instead of this degrading show.
Normally people say bully like it's a bad thing, but have they tried it? It rules! Punches make me feel good.
So that's two people that need legs.
Ah, Jays, the greatest show on earth. As long as you don't let yourself feel empathetic for the real guy.
So we can't really... Yeah.
Wrong sticker.
Yeah, the only item we currently have is helium gas, so that's not gonna work here. So let's keep going and find more items. Where is that first domino? Also, there's some basic platforming, but we're mostly looking for that.
Whoa!
Oh, it's the same. Interesting. So it's a just clone of the last one. Okay, so we can put him to sleep pretty easy. And that will... Oh, never mind, there's a second one. Probably should have looked into that one first. What's he got to say for himself?
Burn, burn, burn! Who has a
world's heart now. Burn, 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 fire, burn.
You see, this is the kind of game that will probably get Let's Played a lot on YouTube, and I'll hate everyone that does that. You wanna know why? You wanna know why I would hate that? Because frankly, all of the work is being done by the game right here. I'm not doing anything. All I'm doing is eventually adding in some commentary. It's just like you're making money from someone else's work. It's bullshit. Alright. Okay, so we now have fire. I guess that's convenient. Let's see what else we got. Fire in here.
Sonny! You're leaving the crowds waiting. The show must go on.
Dad, I'm scared. I told you, I'm afraid of heights.
They're not heights once you hit the bottom. Jump, dang it.
Dad, I don't want to fall to my death. Please stop hitting my hands.
Next time, I'm not bringing the inflatable hammer.
Interesting. Can I steal his oxygen supply?
Work.
Apparently not. Interesting.
Jump right now.
Come on, we're not that high up. What? What's happening? Help me, son.
Dad, I can't. If I let go, I'll die.
Help me, please.
Dad, I'll die.
I'm not sure if I've made the situation better or worse.
That won't stick.
Can we set him on fire?
That won't stick.
Apparently not. Okay.
That doesn't work.
And we can't get access to any of those items up there, interestingly enough. All right, well, let's have a listen
here. Oh, great, now I'm gonna die, and my dad is a balloon. That second fortune cookie I got was also right. I need to stop eating at Crazy Jack's crazy but insanely accurate fortune cookie restaurant.
I confess I cannot see the attraction to being fired out of a cannon, but I do see the attraction of being responsible for the safety of those who do choose this path.
The dialogue in this game is absolutely fantastic. Alright, let's fire him out of the cannon with the fire, surely. There we go.
That was awesome!
I'm not sure if this has helped, but I've just burned away two of my items, so I assume I can grab that, which I can. Alright. I wonder if I can use this for anything whatsoever. Okay. Oh, lovely.
What are you aiming at? How come we're not hitting the usual wall?
Well, this could be amusing. Am I gonna have to get more fire? I guess I'm gonna have to go back. Okay, so the items respawn once you've used them. That makes sense. So take the fire, shoot it at that, knock down the clown, and hilarity ensues. Go. Or maybe not.
Right on target. Right.
This isn't part of the end.
Dad, I've got you.
Whoa! This is an amazing trick! You invented this yourself?
I kinda... You know, it's not so scary when we're both hanging here together.
This is the best trick ever! This is perfect! You're perfect! We'll never do that old trampoline trick again! This blows it out of the water! I'm so happy! I love you, son!
Aww. This is all about... making things right again. Through an increasingly contrived set of maneuvers. So I'm not actually sure if that helped anything whatsoever. Let's see if anything's dropped down there that I can make use of.
Okay.
You would have thought maybe the hammer, but apparently not. This is just... I'm not sure why I solved all of this, or if it actually benefited me in any way. Let's listen to them again, see if there's anything in the mine that I can steal.
You know, that wasn't so bad. Heights aren't so scary if you're good at hitting targets.
When I'm full of helium.
Oh, the smile!
I feel.
I'm a horrible person. Okay, so what to do with the smile? Good question. The mouth of an appreciative dad. Hang on a second, hang on. The overall quest has something to do with reuniting that doctor with his father, so I'm going to take that fire as well. I might have to use it later on. So, okay. They've made this increasingly complicated, as you might imagine. Ah, oh, bollocks! So I wonder what the smile is actually for. As I stole an old man's smile, I'm a horrible person. I don't think giving the smile to the doctor, I don't think it's going to be that easy. Somehow, and obviously that stuff doesn't do anything.
Find helium supply and put it inside.
I'm just checking that I'm not missing anything here. Yeah, neither of these are going to help.
Work.
But you can very much do the good old click on everything, rub your face against it until it works idea. Let's see.
Long sticker. Yeah.
Okay, so none of that actually works. That's kind of to be expected. It has to go a little bit further than that. So this is where the puzzle-solving nonsense comes into play and where I will drag this video out till the end of time, most likely. Let's have a look at the map. Does it go any further than the way that I went? Yeah, it looks like you can actually get up there, and there's two more things up to the top. So I just need to somehow avoid those two goons. I don't think the mouth of an appreciative dad is going to help the Helium Girl. Actually, I don't think the Helium Girl even has one of those spots, because you'll notice here that there's these little circles that indicate you can stick something there. Pretty sure the Helium Girl doesn't have one of those. And I would be correct. Yeah, so the Helium Girl is actually an unimportant NPC. Why can't I... My jump... Why is my jump stop working? This is weird. Okay, so it's... For some reason, my jump doesn't work anymore, and I don't know why that is. I have no explanation for that. Oh, now it must be a bug. So I went to the map and it broke my jump. Then I went back to the map and it fixed it. So, all right. So there's clearly a bug in the game there. Worth bearing in mind. So really, I need to make my way to the top here, if at all possible. I'm just gonna make sure there's nothing along here. But there are two agents up there. I wonder if I can do the mind thing on both. I might be able to.
Dear mental diary.
Oh. Okay. That does not pause it. All right. So I could take the sleep from one and apply it to the other, I guess. Because I can. I'm pretty sure I can get him without him noticing me.
Whoa.
Okay. So we grab his sleep and then we use his sleep on the other guy who is harder to get around. That makes a hell of a lot more sense. Then we should be able to avoid everything else, in theory. Well, there we go. Avoided the site, all the way up here, and there you go. Cool. Game does a pretty good job of gradually introducing you to concepts. The first one is, oh, take it from the guy and use it on him. The second guy, oh, it's take it from one guy and use it on the other. So you can, I think you can see where the puzzles are going to end up going. Let's see what's in here.
Excuse me.
Oh, yes, hello. Well, take a good look. Here I am, the bearded lady. Isn't that crazy? Doesn't that mess with your ideas of gender and beauty?
I guess.
Well, soak it up, because there's no reasons.
This game clearly has far more meaning behind it than Gone Home.
Easiest job in the world. It's amazing what a little super glue, a shaved dog, and a lot of patience can do.
Hello. So we can steal super glue.
This is super glue. Like, really super glue.
What the? Oh. Interesting. Okay. That's cool, because the levels were starting to get a little bit large. So you can teleport either side. I'm going to check that I haven't missed anything here. Probably the map's going to say no. Okay, so I've got everything that I possibly could have over here. So this is going to teleport me to the other side of the level. To be fair, this is only slightly more of a game than Gone Home is.
That won't stick.
Well, as you might imagine, yeah. So the glue's not going to do anything here. So let's try and figure it out without just randomly clicking on everything, because that somehow seems like it would take away from the experience. I have a feeling if I get some legs, I'll be able to glue them here.
Wrong stick.
Oh, okay, I have an idea. Put the glue on the trampoline so that when they do their trick the next time, they get stuck and maybe I can steal some legs or some crap.
One more time, folks.
There we go.
The trampoline privilege maneuver. Put your backs into it, boys.
Not a problem. Get ready to have your mind's body slammed.
Not again.
Wait a second. Your legs are tinier than mine. You've been faking this for years, Gigator.
Library school, here I come.
Oh, our wrestling / bullying careers.
Well then. Incidentally to the chat, by the way, Twitch has currently about a minute long delay, meaning that anything you say, I've probably already done, so don't start with that. Okay. And the mouse disappeared for no reason. weird minor glitches with
the
controls.
In the wrestling area. Do you ever give any thought to being paid to push other men around?
You know, if I could get on the radio, there'd be no way for the audience to know that the triplets aren't here anymore.
Hoax, the triplets just threw a bad guy wrestler into the moon and then punched him on the nose when he landed. I can't believe my eyes! You should, though.
Cool. So we now have legs, so we will give the legs to that, so this is where the dominoes start to fall.
Ah, oh, perfect. Legs out of nowhere. This will definitely be all I need in my eternal afterlife.
Goodbye, sweetie. I loved you more than I love even magic itself. Which is too bad, because if I studied magic harder, you wouldn't have died.
Okay, I'm glad that's done. So, handsome, how long do you think it'll be before you get back into dating?
Oh, I don't know, a few...
minutes?
Well, that'd be quite the trick.
Okay, so now we steal the turban.
It's against my professional code to flirt with patrons.
Oh, come on!
Something about him is just magic. It's against...
I want to steal that! I guess I can't steal that. That's weird. Because it is... It seems like it's a sticker, but I can't do anything with it. I wonder if maybe there's a way to access it.
My wife wouldn't want me to grieve for too long, right? She'd probably think it was way cool if I kissed on somebody I just paid money to.
Lol.
I think that's what she would do for sure.
Okay, that's a little... So that's a little odd now, because I can't click that sticker. There's no action sticker there. That looks like a sticker, but I can't get access to it. It's got the white outline. So that's a little bit strange. Can't set that on fire. It's just not clickable. It legitimately isn't clickable. You need interaction circle for that to actually work. So there must be one more stage to this. The question would be what exactly? Let's check the map and see if we haven't missed anything. There's a couple of things up there. Can we use that trampoline now? No. No, we've already been up there, unless things have changed. I love the drawings in the back is absolutely fantastic. You'll notice that it actually indicate where certain things are. Like, the bearded lady's actually up there. That's where the wrestlers were. It's pretty neat. I like that. It may just be bugged, yeah. So, that could be a problem. If it is bugged, I might try and reload it. Well, I only have two stickers, so I should be able to carry the third. That could be buggy. All right, let's find a save point first before we do any of this.
I've taken some of our planet's finite healing.
Okay. There should be one along here. And then we'll try reloading the game and see if we can pick it up. Yeah, it's either that or I have to do something else to gain access to it. But I've never had to do that with a sticker before, so that doesn't really make a huge amount of sense. Question marks at the top. Yeah, I'm not sure what those would be, because I was up there before. All right, so in this case, I can probably just ignore them. There we go. This was the same as last time, wasn't it? I think it was just the fire again.
I'm carrying fire.
That's just fire. I'm not sure if there's another item here that I somehow missed. Going all the way back to the graveyard doesn't seem to make a lot of sense either. Unless there's something up here? No, that's where we were then. Okay. Alright, well in that case, I'm gonna go back here and I'm gonna load the save file and see if I can gain access to that turbine. Because I need to know if it's actually a bug or if it's an intended feature of the game. Alright. Let's try... Someone's mentioning the bearded lady again. That apparently there was an item there. Okay, we'll go check that out. Alright, so we've got to steal this guy's sleep and then use it on the other guy. There we go. Nope, there we go. Use that on him. Sweet. Jump all the way up here. Oh! I guess I woke up the other one. That wasn't so good. See if we can sneak around him. Yes, we kind of can. Just gotta be a little bit quicker up here, there we go. Problem solved. Alright, let's go into the bearded lady's mind again, see if there's anything useful.
Easiest job.
No, there's nothing in there.
Easiest job in the world. It's amazing what a little super glue, a shaved dog, and a lot of patience can
do. Yeah, there's nothing in there whatsoever. The map doesn't indicate that there's any actual item here. Like, there is this, but that's just background stuff. I think if there is an item, it shows up on the map. Okay, let's go back to the start of the area again. See what we can find. This is where this is. There is a question mark, like, back further in the previous area. Yeah, I think those were background characters. Like, I don't think you could actually interact with them. Yeah, so I definitely cannot click on that turbine at all.
It's against my professional.
Which is weird, because it's very clearly... Oh, I would imagine... Well, the thing is, like, I can't attach anything to these guys. Unless there's some other way I could maybe grab the sleep action, use that on one of these. I'm going to try that first. I'm going to try the sleep action, then I'll go back to the graveyard and see if I'm missing something there. The logic is certainly getting a bit fuzzy, which is to be expected from a like a kind of puzzle point-and-click platformer thingy. Okay, so we're going to steal the sleep one. I'm going to try using that on the medium to see if we can steal the turbine. No, you can't actually use that on either of them. They're like background characters now, so... Yeah, I guess if there is no circle on it, then you can't use it. Okay. The only other possibility is I could send him to sleep.
It was worth a shot.
Well, that doesn't work.
That doesn't work.
Alright, let's go back to the graveyard. Someone's saying you have to walk for... Oh, hang... Whoa. You can walk into the back? The game never explained that either! So it's not actually 2D at all, because you can actually walk to and towards the fucking hell. Oh, so you can grab it, no problem I absolutely hate it when games don't explain that. Why would I have thought that you could walk forwards and backwards in a 2D bloody platformer? Come on! That was... bullshit. You see what I mean? This is what happens when games don't properly explain those mechanics. Because that's an unusual mechanic. It should tell you about that.
And how does that make you feel? I've pulled back the veil between our world and the next one!
What? Huh?
Are there any spirits with which you would like to speak?
Dad, I want to talk to my dad. He looks a little like me, only he's super old.
Ghost of the skies, old dad, I command you here. But who called me?
Ah!
Dad, it's me. I just wanted to talk to you. To make peace about how you love lobotomies, and I love treating people without cutting into their skulls.
Son, I have a mind to lobotomize you right here! You've been losing this argument for years,
And now even when I'm dead, you drag me back so you can get one last word in? For the selfish, self-interested, totally deserving of a lobotomy actions to do!
Oh, well, there you go. So, basically we wasted the last 15 minutes because the game didn't explain a mechanic at any point during it that was vital to actually progressing. That was lovely. In response to MaxiTB, no, this is not what WTFS should be, because that was 15 minutes of wasted fucking time. Like, that should not have been in a video, right? So, that's why I'm actually doing all this stream stuff, to show you what ends up happening in some of these situations. Like, okay, so I guess I can add the smile here.
If there's a problem that can't be solved by physically modifying someone's brain, I haven't found it yet. I should have cut out his brain when I had the chance. And another thing, son. I love you. Even though we have different approaches, we're both on the same team. Just don't want to see people be sad. You're doing good, son, and I'm proud of you. You know that, right?
I do now, Dad.
That's my cue. You be good, boy.
Hooray! At last, an emotional breakthrough. Closure.
Huh? What? What happened? What'd I miss?
I talked to my dad. He's a ghost, and we talked, and we worked things out. I can go back to work now. Thank you.
What? Ghosts? Oh, that's crazy talk. You're crazy.
What? No, I'm not crazy. He was a vision from beyond the grave. I'm not crazy. Next.
I guess that's me.
Excellent, excellent. Sit down here. And tell me all about how whatever your issue is makes you feel.
Oh, well, I've got this giant spaghetti arm that comes out of my head. And only I can see it. Oh, but it lets me read people's minds.
Telepathy, huh? That definitely sounds crazy. Ooh, but before I give you my diagnosis, there's one thing I'd like to try. Follow the pendulum. You are getting sleepy. You are about to tell me all your secrets.
So, dang sleepy.
And there you go. Okay. Ooh, hello. I was about to say... There we go. I was about to say, this is probably a good time to kind of wrap the stream up. I think I've got to the point where I know what I'm going to say about this game, so that should work. Yeah, it's like chapter 5. It's a good time to stop. The kind of annoying thing, I suppose, is that a lot of that time was actually taken up by listening to dialogue, but hey, there you go. Yeah, this is a good point to put it in at, I think. Yeah, that should probably do it. I also want to try and do a video where I'm not spoiling the plot. I think doing the Dreamland sequence is probably the best. So, yeah, that should do it. Okay, cool. All right, we're going to wrap up here. I actually have to do this video because I'm, well, going out to the movies tonight to go watch the other Hunger Games thing. And the showing's at, like, 9:40 or something like that. So I've got to get this video done before then. And then I will... Well, I'm not going to give you conclusions now, because then you wouldn't watch the video. So I'll tell you what my conclusions are in the actual video itself. And I hope to be able to do more of this. And depending on what the game is, depends on how long it will actually take for us to do the stream or whatever. Bear in mind, I won't be able to do it for everything because some of the bigger games that I've got, in fact, even a lot of the games, actually have embargoes on them. So I'll have to actually do the research secretly because otherwise I'd be breaking the embargo agreement. So there you go. Interesting comment there from someone in the chat, actually. Bob1T says that they don't use the 3D mechanic once, and the stealth sections get annoying in the late game. Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. Like, I was getting the feeling that they might. Like, there's some interesting functionality to them, but yeah, I have a feeling that would probably get pretty annoying. I'm hoping that when I actually do the video, I'll be able to blitz through a couple of chapters, because I won't put all the voice acting in there for the actual video itself. I'll demonstrate it a couple of times for the purposes of critique and demonstration, and then I'll just skip the rest. So hopefully we'll get to see some of those stealth sections in action in the later game. Yeah, this format seems to work. I'll do it more often. It's really cool to be able to show the earlier parts of the game and also to get some information from the chat, particularly in the case of Stick It to the Man, because this game's actually been out on PlayStation since last month. So that helps a lot. So we got some good information there. We're able to crack some of those more ridiculous puzzles. But yeah, I have a feeling the central theme of that video is going to be the annoyance of not explaining your fucking game mechanics. But yeah, aside from that, it's actually pretty cool. Yeah. The research from the streams will be left up for the subs, by the way. All the subscribers will be able to watch the research VODs. The research VODs will not go up on YouTube because that would obviously defeat the point of the exercise. But absolutely, I will leave the VODs up for you. Yeah. And I know, I already knew what the length of the game was because, hey, it's been out for a few weeks, so it's easy to find game lengths when games have been out for that long. Alright, cool. Well, I'm gonna go and actually do the video on this game now then. Thank you very much for watching, folks. This format obviously works pretty well, so we'll do more of it. And thanks to the new subscribers, by the way. Very much appreciate it. I'd like to list you all off, but Twitch takes about 30 minutes to actually send the subscriber list to me, and it's out of date when it gets here, so... But thank you to everyone that recently subscribed during the stream. We'll be doing a lot more of this. I'll see you next time.